Morning everyone, and thanks for tuning into the Forensics Detailing channel again. Today we're going to be doing a video piece on two other offerings from the Flex Power Tool Company, following on from our review of the PE8/480 last time, which you can also see on the channel. So today we are going to be reviewing Flex's full-size rotary offering of the Flex PE14-2 150 and the Flex PE14-1 180. We'll follow the same format as the other video, where we talk about all of the technical specifications of both these rotary polishers, and then we will look at pad and plate options, then we will demo the tools in use, and then we'll do a sort of final kind of conclusion summary on and a rating, I suppose, of these rotary polishers, and whether or not you should go and buy these polishers as either a professional or a hobbyist detailer. And that's it. We'll keep the video short and sweet and hopefully informative. Okay guys, so we're back now doing the technical specifications section of these two tools. We're going to start with the specs of the PE14-2 150. So first of all, this tool is what 99% of automotive detailers will opt for over the two tools, the 14-2 150 and the 14-1 180, and we'll talk about what the 180 is for specifically. But for general automotive clear coat and automotive paint polishing, the PE14-2 is the one that you would typically opt for, and we'll go through its specifications now. So the first thing, have a look at the tool there. Again, the first thing that I want to mention about this tool is the weight. So this is 2.3 kilograms, so that is light for a full-sized rotary offing, and it's light and it's quite compact. And just to prove that, here is kind of my DeWalt rotary which I use. It's a lot bigger, and I can tell you it's a lot heavier than my Flex tool, and you can really feel it just from holding it, and I'm right-handed as well. This tool feels a hell of a lot heavier. It is a hell of a lot heavier, about sort of 30% heavier, and less ergonomic as well. So that's the first reason, or the first massive thing to say about this tool. It's lightweight for a full-size, full-powered rotary. The second thing is the ergonomics. So we have this nice slimline kind of tool that is designed to be held in one hand, and it feels well balanced more than other rotaries where you've got all this heavy weight and it's kind of pulling your arm over. That makes a hell of a difference when you're doing vertical panels as well and you're supporting more of the weight of the machine. So yeah, the machine has this kind of handle grip on the end. So if you're doing horizontal panels, then 9 times out of 10 you won't need the stick grip, which is available to go in either one of these slots on either side. I'll just show you that. So a lot of people might be using this tool, especially because it's so weight, so light with no stick grip. But I would still use the stick grip when I'm doing vertical panels, so you can hold it there. This hand is also kind of all rubber around here, so if you do accidentally hit the tool or bump the tool against clear coat, it's not going to scratch it. So it's going to reduce scratching with that rubber handle. It's also going to reduce noise and vibration being made of rubber rather than just kind of like a more rigid plastic. So that's an important point. The fact that this is easier to hold, well balanced and lightweight, means that if you're operating the tool for long periods of time, like between 5 and 10 hours, the fatigue on your body is going to be a lot less. It really will be as well. So that would be one of the main reasons why a professional will be opting for this tool. No idea what's going on with that screen behind. Okay, the next thing to talk about, it's got the standard M14 14mm axle that all rotaries have and that you want, that makes it compatible with most backing plate systems and extension bars. Okay, the next thing I want to talk about is the quiet running of this tool. So I'm just going to fire this tool up so you can have a listen. So it's quite a smooth sounding machine. This is on top speed. You can probably hear me speak over the top of it. So it's got quite a high pitched whistle like a jet engine, but it's smooth. At lower speeds, its slowest speed, you can probably hear me quite clearly. That's even with the tool there. It's very quiet on its lowest speeds. On its highest speeds, you would probably want to wear protective headgear if you're doing that, because that whistling sound for hours and hours on end could cause you some problems. But again, compared to my DeWalt, that's a pretty quiet rotary as well. But this is generally, I would say, quieter. You can also feel with a good quality tool like this, the smoothness of the rotation. With some of them, they sound a bit more clunky and rattly, like an old diesel engine. This one sounds like a jet engine, and usually that's indicative of really good cog mechanisms or high quality kind of steel cogs in this machine. So I believe it's made in Germany. It's definitely got a reputation for being very well engineered, and you can hear and feel this when you use it. So that's important. Okay, so that's the lightweight, that's the ergonomics, that's the M14 axle, that's the nice quiet running. What are some of the features of this tool that you might not find on other rotaries? One, its speed is controlled by tachometer. So in other words, if you set this machine to 1200 RPMs, it will measure how fast it's running and it will maintain that speed. If it doesn't have a tachometer, if it's a cheapo kind of rotary, you set it at 1200 RPM, it's guessing how fast it's running based on probably when they set the tool up. If you slow the machine down by putting loads of pressure on it for whatever reason, the machine isn't intelligent enough to know. This will maintain its speed. That makes it more precise and accurate, which is an important thing when you're doing clear coat paint correction, you know. And you can feel that kind of, you know, you want this machine to be constant velocity, basically. It's not over-analyze that. The next thing is it has a temperature monitoring. So if the machine overheats, it will shut down to protect it. Again, you want that. You don't want to blow your tool up for whatever reason. The next thing is it has a safe start on it. So if you lose your power when you're working on the tool, you have a power cut and you leave the tool on because it's got a trigger lock. When the power comes back on, the tool won't start back up again, which could be a really nice feature, and that could save you from damaging a car if you have to leave an area in a rush for whatever reason, you know. Okay. What else do we need to talk about? We need to talk about the ventilation of this machine. I've just lost my, where's my back screen gone? come back to me. Let's see if I can get this back. Gotta love computers. It was working. There we go. Oh, blimey. So there, on the next slide, actually, it comes up. It's going to show the cooling system on this machine. There you go. So it draws air in through these two ducts at the back, and they draw through where the motor is, the part that gets hot, and then they're blown out here. This tool is renowned for staying cool. A common problem with rotaries is when you're using them at slow speeds, when you're perhaps doing dueling or, you know, something that requires you to operate the tool for a long time at low speeds. A lot of them overheat at that point. This tool doesn't suffer from that because just the way that the cooling system's been tested and engineered, it will maintain its temperature at low speed. So it has a very, very good reputation for being able to be used for a long time without overheating. So that's important. Okay, next thing to talk about is the speed range. So they've put the speed range on the tool, which I really like. I like to be able to, I don't want to just a set of numbers there because every tool's different. You've got five or six, you've got to remember them all. So it's great that they've put that on there. That's a really intelligent thing to do. It says here that speed 1 is 600 RPM and speed 6 is 2100. Well, actually, if you go down to speed 1 and operate on half trigger, this machine's minimum speed is 3800 RPM. So that's fantastic. So that allows you to go below 600 RPM, maybe for fine dueling. I wouldn't duel at that. I'd usually duel at 600 and above. But also maybe for laying out products at very low speed. It just gives you a capability. It's nice to have that real slow speed capability. What else? The maximum speed, 2100. Fantastic. Like I've said a few times, I tend to only go up to about 1400, and most of the time I stay below that. So this is more than fast enough for me. There are other people more experienced than me that will use these at higher speeds for different jobs, maybe headlight restoration or whatever. So 2100 seems a sensible higher speed to me, but I will not ever need to go that high generally. Okay, its maximum plate size, 150 millimeters. That's where it gets the name P14-2150. So that's the backing plate size in millimeters. 150 millimeters is 6 inches. That plate will support a 200 millimeter pad, which is 8 inches. So you can put quite large pads on this. I don't tend to use them with pads that big. I would be using pads between probably 5 and 6 inches on this on a flexible backing plate for me. But that's all about personal preference. It has a 1400 watt motor, output motor, so it's got plenty of power. Like you say, that's quite important. What else have we got? We talked about the stick handle. No need for a bale handle because it's kind of got an integrated bale style handle on there. Yeah, so that is all the technical specification which I wanted to cover and I'd made a note of. The only other thing we've got to mention is the price, which is really important. So this tool retails at £300 for what you're seeing here. The box set I showed you earlier on is £400 with the tool. So for £100 you get that nice kind of hard shell case. You get a few pads, you get some compounds, you get a backing plate, and you get a microfiber cloth. So you might like that. That sounds like, £300 sounds like a lot of money. Like I say, you can go and buy a rotary for next to nothing, like any power tool out there. There will be good quality expensive ones, and there will be very cheap ones that will do the job. Now, it depends what sort of guy you are. Are you the guy that wants to go and buy sort of like a 50 to 80 quid rotary polisher? You know, if you do, you'll have a machine that's probably able to spin as fast as this. It'll weigh a lot more, probably make a lot more noise, might not last as long. Okay, what I will say is £300. If you go and look for rotaries with these specs, at this weight, with this reputation that's made in Germany or made anywhere else other than China, there will be, I don't think, any other offerings at that sort of price. There are a few other specialist companies making these kind of quite lightweight full-size rotaries, and they're charging more. So I'm actually of the opinion £300 is quite a reasonable price point for this tool. Like I say, if you want to go and buy cheap tools, there are a million one options in buying cheap tools in the world. This isn't a cheap tool. This is a high quality tool for professional use. If you're a hobbyist detailer like me and you like using good tools rather than cheap ones and you don't mind paying a little bit extra, then do not have any concerns about the quality and value for money of this tool. It's top notch and it's highly rated. It's been around for about 5 years, so there's no little design niggles. It's not something that's hot off the press that's just gone out there. It's tried and tested. So that's enough waffle from me. I've covered everything I wanted to cover. We're trying to keep this nice and simple. So like I say, in summary, this is a compact, lightweight, high performance, high quality, German engineered rotary polisher, the PE14-2150. Okay guys, so we're just gonna conclude the technical review section of this video piece by doing a quick review of the 14-1180, the Flex PE even. Okay, so this is the brother of the one we just reviewed, the 14-2. The main difference is that we need to talk about the function. Why would you buy this tool instead of the other one? So this tool is a more specialized tool for buffing larger areas. So it offers a larger backing plate and pad combo size than its brother tool. And it offers a slightly higher torque range, I'm told. And it will maintain those torques at even lower speeds. And it runs at a different speed range than the 14-2, and that is a lower speed. So lower speed ranges, higher torque with bigger pads for buffing things with big areas, like the hulls of boats, like aeroplanes, like buses and coaches and that sort of stuff. So 99% of you will be wanting the 14-2 for automotive cars, but a few of you that are probably professionals might be interested in this tool for those other functions we just talked about. Okay, in terms of technical specifications, this tool is physically on the surface identical. You know, it looks the same, sorry, is the best way of putting it, as the PE14-2. If you had them both in your hands, you wouldn't be able to tell the difference unless you saw the model label and the speed dial settings, as far as I'm aware. Okay. The first technical difference is the maximum backing plate that this supports is 180 millimeters, which is 7 inches. And that 7-inch backing plate will support a pad size, maximum pad size of 250 millimeters, which is 10 inches. So much bigger pads, or significantly bigger pads. The next thing is the speed range. It says here speed 1 through to 6, speed 1 is 380, speed 6 is 1380. The actual minimum speed though, if you're on half trigger on speed setting 1, is 250. So this goes incredibly slow. So that's really gonna be for softer kind of fine dueling of really soft kind of clear coats. Even then I can't envisage something spinning that slow and being functional, but I've never buffed different surfaces. I've never buffed gel coats and planes and all that sort of stuff, so I don't know anything about that. But I assume that that speed function is more suitable for those sorts of things. The other thing is obviously that maximum 13800. Okay, that's about the speed that I never really tend to exceed that speed. So it's worth mentioning you could quite happily use this tool to do paint correction on cars, you know, up at getting close to 1400 there. But your P14-2 is your better option for that. Like I say, this is slightly more specialized variant of that tool. So if you're just focused on cars, go for the 14-2, not the 14-1. The rest of the technical specification, the weight, the power, the cooling system, everything, it's all identical to the other tool. So really this was just a very quick side note to introduce you to this tool. It wouldn't have been worth doing a full video piece on it because they're so similar. So hopefully we've covered the technical specs now for the two tools. And the most important thing is you know the difference between the PE14-1 and the PE14-2. So 1, boats, plane, coaches, 2, cars. Okay guys, so we're just gonna wrap this video up now. I've been polishing this tool for about 5 or 6 hours today. My conclusions on this tool, First thing is, I love the fact that the tool is lighter. When you're using this tool and you're kind of, it's always a balancing act of trying to make sure you've got your tool nice and flat and level on your clear coat where you're hitting. And with a rotary, you're constantly making that adjustment. And if you're not flat, you're getting pushed and pulled all over the place, especially at higher speeds with bigger pads. So this makes a hell of a difference, that extra weight. And even holding it without the stick, I really like using this tool. And you can hold it quite delicately and quite precisely. That's the first thing I noticed when using this over my DeWalt. So my fatigue in my body is less. I feel pretty good. Won't need a hot bath or anything like that. So in terms of finding fault with the tool, I honestly can't. I was quite happy with my DeWalt, but I seriously consider trading it in and going to get one of these, because of the fact that when you are using it to polish a car, the main thing is the less fatigue for me on the body. That would be the big tick, the showstopper, the weight, and therefore the adjustments that you can make, everything is just a little bit easier. The control of the tool through the trigger and the trigger locks and the thumb mechanism are fantastic. It all feels just right. So yeah, I cannot find fault with this tool. 10 out of 10. If you're a professional, should you use one? Absolutely, and most professionals know about this tool and will be using them. If you don't, then I highly recommend it to you. Again, to the hobbyist detailer, if you want the best at a very reasonable price that we talked about earlier on, then you cannot look beyond the Flex PE14-2150 and its brother tool, the 14-1180. So thanks everyone for watching this review. Tune in next time. We'll be doing some more power tool reviews and some more best of videos, and maybe some more detailing kind of things like engine bay cleanings and all that sorts of stuff. So there's more to come on forensics. If you like what you're seeing, please like the channel and please subscribe. Thank you very much. Have a great evening.